Today from the robodebt report, pressure mounting on former PM Scott Morrison to resign. Today, reporter Gabrielle Boyle is in Cronulla with that story. In the Shire, Gabby, member for Cook isn't the only position he might lose.
It was just a few short years ago, wasn't it, that ScoMo was an extremely popular politician here on the beaches of Cronulla, very well liked by voters, even so much so that back in 2016 he was given the position of number one ticket holder for the Cronulla Sharks. He could often be seen on the sidelines cheering on his team, but his popularity has certainly dropped. In fact, they're considering dropping him, we understand, from that position of number one ticket holder, and his future in politics remains in limbo, with some in the party suggesting that he no longer has their support. And it all comes, of course, after this latest Royal Commission, the Robodebt Commission, finding many flaws in how this whole process played out. On the streets of Cronulla this morning, it seems opinion is divided over whether ScoMo has a future in politics.
Look, I don't speak about Scott Morrison because I don't really want to even hear his name. So there you go.
I think everyone's a bit over him, to be honest. Might not be up with what we need as a country.
Oh, I always like Scotty.
Yes. What do you like about him?
I don't know. He's just got that way. He's an Aussie. He's a Cronulla. He can't be doing things wrong.
Yeah, it certainly will be interesting to see the next chapter of his career, Carlos.
There's nothing quite like the Shire. I love it. Gabby, thank you.
Welcome back. Well, Scott Morrison's seat in Parliament is under heightened scrutiny this morning following the damning findings from the Robodebt Royal Commission. Joining us to discuss the news headlines is Minister for Government Services and the NDIS, Bill Shorten, and 3AW's Neil Mitchell. Thank you both for your time. Bill, should Scott Morrison go?
That's up to Scott Morrison and the Liberal Party. But I do think, having read what the Royal Commission has said about Mr Morrison, I'll let the public make up their mind. You wouldn't want that written about yourself if you were a self-respecting member of Parliament. It's embarrassing and humiliating. Mr Morrison point blank says it's all wrong. I'd just invite people to read the Royal Commission and make up their own mind if this forensic analysis of his mistakes, instituting an unlawful scheme against 500,000 vulnerable Aussies, see what you think when you read what they say about him.
Yeah, I mean, Neil, the findings of the Royal Commission are just the latest in a number of inquiries about this failed scheme. If Mr Morrison decides to dig his heels in, does this impact the Liberal Party's credibility?
Yeah, of course it does. Bill's being unusually restrained today. I think Scott Morrison should go, and I think Peter Dutton should tell him publicly to go. That should help to restore a bit of credibility. You can't... Look, we want the right people in Parliament committing to the people in the Parliament, and that's Scott Morrison on this judgment and various other judgments has lost the right to be there, I think. I mean, not legally, and it would cost over $1 million for a by-election, but to retain the integrity and the standing of the Parliament, I think we need to do it. But Bill, I don't know if you've read the sealed section, Bill. It's a bit like Girly magazine, isn't it? The sealed section. Do you know who's been charged, and can you tell us who hasn't been charged?
Bill?
No, I don't know. The Royal Commission was... The Royal Commission was something which I pushed for from opposition. When we pushed for it, the Liberals said there was nothing to see here. Mm. Well, thank goodness we got it. But one thing I hadn't expected was the Royal Commission to say that there'll be a section to do with the potential prosecution and referral to other authorities about individuals against whom she's made an adverse finding. I've mixed emotions about that. I would like to know, but I also respect the Commission has said that she didn't want to prejudice these prosecutions, and I guess there is a strong point there which you don't want to get in your own way, and I'd rather justice and accountability than just dropping names out there, but I can see why people would want to know them.
Yeah, well, it's likely...
Sarah, in all seriousness, Bill Shorten should be congratulated on this, and I don't do that often, but he's been running this very hard from the start, and he's done an excellent job, and he's been proven right by this Royal Commission report. My question to Bill now, though, is, are you going to pay compensation to these people? They've had the $1.8 billion in repayment. Do they get compensation as well or not?
The Royal Commissioner turned her mind to this. She made the following remarks, Neil. She said that a general sort of scheme would be administratively more costly to run than the money that would get paid out, because there's so many different individual sort of categories of people who were caught up in this unlawful scheme. She does, though, make a point, which no doubt the lawyers are going to comb over pretty carefully, about whether or not the elements of a tort of public misfeasance could be established.
Yeah, I mean,
so needless to say, the lawyers have already started writing. So that I don't know if it's a closed topic yet, Neil, by what she said, but she was pretty clear that a general scheme wouldn't be the go here.
The whole thing was very ugly and it should never, ever be repeated.